Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14 Beta 2 and Public Beta 2 have been out for a few days. I've been using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and I also have it on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. Now, before I talk about iOS 14, let's talk about iOS 13.6 GM. Now, I took a lot of this information from the YouTube community poll, which I'll talk about a little bit later and read some of your comments, but the first thing is, with iOS 13.6 GM or Golden Master, which is the final version that will come out to the public, unless Apple finds a few other issues with it, it's the final version that should release probably this coming week. So probably sometime this week it will come out with all the different features I went over, and you can expect a video on that. But most people are saying there are zero issues with iOS 13.6. Occasionally you might have an app that has issues, but that person would need to update their app. As far as performance and smoothness and everything from opening apps to battery life, they seem to be pretty solid. And in fact, speaking of battery life, I know a lot of you know already that I don't use this iPhone 11 as my main phone since I've been using iOS 14. So I've been testing it on this a little bit, but battery life has been better than iOS 13.5.1, according to most people. And so this one has not been on a long time, but most people are getting the 8 to 12 hours of screen on time that you would expect depending on which phone you're using. So if you're using an iPhone 11, you can expect about 7 or 8 hours of screen on time. If you're using an iPhone 11 Pro Max with iOS 13.6, expect 10 to 12 hours of screen on time with that version. Most bugs are fixed, and they should be at this point. It's very late in the game with iOS 13.6, and basically just expect it to be a minor update with those few features I mentioned earlier in the week when they released it. So it's really a nice version, finally, of iOS 13, but iOS 14 has the new features and seems to be just as stable, almost at this point, as iOS 13 has been since about January. So iOS 14 Beta 2 does have a few bugs from here and there, but compared to previous betas, such as iOS 13 Beta 1, Beta 2, the public beta, this is a lot more stable and far more usable than those versions were. And that's a good sign early on. Now, we see this every other year. Most things are nice and fast, scrolling through different pages. Performance is generally pretty good, but I am having a couple issues from time to time where it locks up a little bit. Sometimes some of the widgets don't refresh 100% right on time, but that's to be expected. They're still working on that. And I still have that storage bug. So if I go into General, then I go to my iPhone storage, you'll see I'm using almost all of my storage. So there's not really a reason for that other than that it's a bug. And then if this continues to happen, I'll just reset the phone and it will fix that problem. But you'll see system is using 12.88 gigabytes. Other will be using 100 gigabytes or almost 200 gigabytes. So once it updates here, but you'll see that it's using hundreds of gigabytes, and that's the other that we see at the top. Now, other than that, I really haven't had too many issues. There are a few apps that don't work properly for some people, such as Pokemon Go, and many people are having that storage bug. So I would expect the maybe beta 3 or maybe a few more betas to fix that, but it's hard to say. But either way, make sure you're reporting it in the feedback app so that Apple knows it's going on. I'm sure they already have an idea, and I'm not sure where it is in here, but if we look for feedback, we can find it, report it in the feedback app, and make sure that you just note that so that Apple knows it's a problem for you. And the more they get, the more information they can get, and they can fix it. Now, most people are saying that it's pretty steady with occasional lockups like I'm having. Most of the time, scrolling is nice and fast. You might have seen that little stutter there, but most of the time, it's pretty good. Now, with my iPad Pro, iPadOS 14 seems to be pretty solid as well. I've had very few issues. The only issue I've really noticed are input issues. So if you go into Safari and maybe you want to type in a web address, occasionally I'll have an input error there where it just won't work properly, and that's usually due to the Magic Keyboard. So I'll have to unplug it from the Magic Keyboard, put it back, and then it works properly. Other than that, I've really had no issues with the iPad OS version of iOS 14, so it seems to be doing really well there. Now, most of you say the exact same thing. You're either having the storage bug, you're having a couple issues with widgets, or a couple issues with Pokemon Go. As far as performance, though, everything seems to be pretty good, pretty smooth. Everything's what you would expect, or really better than what you would expect for this early in a beta. Now, as far as battery life for me, well, it's been okay. It's still better than beta 1, but it's not as good as iOS 13.6 was for me. I have 97% battery health on this iPhone 11 Pro Max. And if we take a look at the last 10 days, well, yesterday I had 2 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 53 minutes of screen off time playing music and things like that. At that point, I only used 25% of my battery. So if we used it throughout the day like that, well, I'm going to hit that 8 to 10, maybe 12 hours of screen on plus screen off time together. So I'm seeing much better battery life than I was before. If we take a look at maybe the previous version, you'll see I was using 50% of my battery life and only getting 2 hours and 42 minutes of screen on time. We're doing much better with the past couple of days with screen on time. So that's a good sign with iOS 14. Of course, Apple's not prioritizing battery life until closer to the final release, when that becomes more of a priority. Now, based off the YouTube community poll, many of you were mentioning things like battery and sometimes the phone heating up, but most people said it was pretty good. You can see all of the issues here. And also, here are all of the devices that you were using for those of you that commented in the poll. So I really appreciate you mentioning the devices. Seems quite a few of you are using iPhone 11s, iPhone SE, and some other devices as well. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now with the YouTube community poll, thanks to everyone that voted, I only made this live, well, not too long ago. You'll see it has 9.8K votes, or 9,800 plus votes. So I really appreciate all that voted. And some people commented and said, why didn't you split up the OS? Well, actually, you can only put this amount of polling options. So I'd have to do two separate polls, one for each version. Hopefully we can do that later in the future with each version. But you'll see 22% of you said it was great. That's combining both iOS 13.6 GM and iOS 14 beta 2. Only 2% are saying either of them are terrible. 15% are saying they have bugs. I'm really thinking this is more iOS 14. And then 46% of you haven't even updated yet. You're on the public version of iOS 13.5.1 or older, and 15% of you are on Android. And that seems to be fairly consistent. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. I did read all of them prior to making this video. There may be a few new ones, but let's take a look at them. And that's where I compiled all the information I shared with you. Using iOS 13.6 GM on my iPhone 7, pretty much better than iOS 13.5.1. iOS 14 Beta 2, iPhone 10, lots of bugs. If I knew, I would not upgrade. You can downgrade if you have a computer. I have a separate video on how to do that as well. iOS 14 Beta 2 on iPhone 11 and iPad Pro 10.5, great experience so far with no major issues. Only concern is the amount of storage it has taken up. Have had no battery drain issues on either device. I would say the experience on iPhone is better. New widgets are great. Love the new compact Siri and compact call notifications. All in all, very happy so far. No major bugs at all. Can only get better, hopefully. iOS 14 Beta 2 on iPhone 11 Pro Max is going great. I've had one crash, slower internet, screen time widget issues, but that's about it. Of course, there are normal bugs like frame rate drops and lagging, which are still rare. Downgraded from 14 Beta 2 to 13.5.1 and then updated to 13.6 GM. iOS 14 Beta 1 worked pretty good, only minor bugs, but with iOS 14 Beta 2 it got more unstable and good. Bunch of apps wouldn't open, crashed after opening, the weather widget was black and didn't show any data, battery drain was insane, 1 to 2 hours of screen on time, animations are laggy, more like not fluid. So far 13.6 runs solid, which is expected for a GM version. And if you gave it a few hours it would probably get better, but most people are saying Beta 2 is much, much better. On iOS 14, there's a bug that crashes or resets your phone whenever you try to take a photo or record a video in Messenger. I'm wondering if you're talking about Facebook Messenger or something else. They may need to update that app, and it may be conflicting with something. But then someone below said iOS 14 Beta 2, all great so far, apart from my battery life. iOS 14 Beta 2, perfect for me, no bugs or glitches. I'm using iOS 14 Public Beta 2 on my iPhone 11. It's going great, battery life is a bit better, but it still gets a bit hot or heated, which is normal as previous versions. Actually, I haven't faced any bugs or crashing yet. iOS 14 Public Beta 2 on iPhone XR and iPad Pro 10.5. Widgets not always work perfectly well, and changing wallpaper sometimes can be quite a challenge. I've actually experienced that now that you mention it, although that was more of an issue with Beta 1. Everything else works better and faster than on iOS 13.5.1. We'll take a look at a couple more. There were over 300, so it's hard to read all of them, of course. Let's take a look at this one. I have an old iPhone 7 that works pretty well on iOS 14 right now. I think it's even better than an iOS 13's beta was. I use Android 10 as my daily driver because of the risk of using beta software, but it's surprisingly stable with only a few bugs and instances of lag. In other words, I love it. I've been using iOS 14 beta 2 on my iPhone XS Max, and it's been pretty stable besides some tiny visual bugs. iOS 14 public beta is running great on my iPhone SE 2. iOS 14 beta 2 has been running great on my iPhone XR. Battery life is not that great, but oh well. Overall, it's been a pleasant experience. I haven't encountered any bugs. The widgets are working properly now. However, they don't switch to dark mode sometimes when I toggle it on. iPhone 11, love the large weather widget. Better battery than the last beta. A few blips, no big deal. Still loving the variety of wallpapers. And thanks for the compliment. I've had a positive experience on iOS 14 for the most part, and I can't wait to update to the final release. I have iOS 14 on my main phone, and let me tell you, it ain't even bad. The only problem is my battery life, but other than that, it's amazing how stable it is. And so iOS 14 beta 2 seems like it's pretty good for most people. Of course, people are going to have issues. Again, report them to feedback, but I would expect beta 3 either this week or probably on a couple week cycle until we get to August. So it wouldn't surprise me if we have a beta probably in a week after this. So iOS 13.6 this week, released to the public, and probably a beta or public beta 3 or developer beta 3 of iOS 14, probably early next week. Although you never know with Apple, and they could release it whenever they choose. So it could be a couple weeks or it could be next week also. So let me know what you think about that in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.